bad boys to Muslims, a growing number of rap artists are leaving the bad boy hip-hop lifestyle for a more spiritual one. The Canadian Dao Association says an increasing number of rappers this year embraced Islam or acknowledge they previously embraced Islam. Among the names, Busta Rhymes, Loon, Napoleon, Castro and Raekwon. Well, Amir Junaid Muhaddith, better known by his stage name Loon, is one artist hoping to change the lyrics and message of rap following his own religious conversion. Loon was part of P. Diddy's Bad Boy Records. He accepted Islam in 2008 on a tour in Dubai. He joins me now from Saudi Arabia, where he's just finished performing an Umrah or minor religious pilgrimage. Thanks so much for joining us. You kind of look a little bit different to me today than how we've been seeing you in those pop videos. Is Loon still in there somewhere?
Nah, Loon is working his way out of my system, you know. Just happy to be, you know, accepting Islam and finding the peace of mind that I was always searching for in the music business. And it was very difficult to find this place in my life now, but thanks to Islam, I've been able to, you know, complete my search, and now I'm very much at peace.
So I take it you're no longer a bad boy?
No, bad boy days are over. Now I'm what you call a good boy.
All right, I want to forgive me for taking our viewers back to a little bit of the bad boy Loon days. I want to just play a piece of your music here just to refresh everyone's memory of how Loon used to look like.
You might have met a lot of women in my lifetime, but see, it's not a lot of women that got the right mind. I done had pretty chicks with all the right features and hood rat chicks that only rock sneakers, cell phones and beepers and know how to treat you. You break a heart, shit, walk out, leave you. I find a girl I'm a keeper, cause now I'm getting money and the game getting deeper. You want some real...
Well, I guess the question now is, will you continue to rap?
Well, right now I'm very much focusing on, you know, studying Islam and becoming more knowledgeable of the deen, because, you know, being in a position of influence, you know, I have to be able to, you know, protect myself in ways, you know, the media sometimes, you know, try to use these transitions that artists make and try to make it, you know, saying an opportunity to make a mockery of Islam or whatever faith a person might choose. So I'm, you know, very much an advocate of trying to study the deen and become more knowledgeable of Islam. And,
right,
you know, Allah knows best.
In addition to studying your new religion, I understand you're also working with another group of rap artists to try and change the message of rap itself. Is that possible? I mean, rap hails from the hardened neighborhoods of the West. The lyrics sometimes attack, threaten, insult others. Can rap be rap without all of that?
Well, that's something I think all of us as artists who've, you know, saying, accepted Islam are struggling with, because it's a very, very fine line, you know what I'm saying? With me, I actually really love the music, but it's the lifestyle that's really the bad influence, you know? The music sometimes can be geared towards things that influence people to do positive things, but the actual, you know, part that deters people from, you know, practicing their faith or concentrating on positive things is really the lifestyle.
Now tell us, how did the rest of your entourage, how did they end up coming over? All of them, you said, accepted this way of life.
They all accepted Islam. Edie was the first one that accepted Islam. I remember talking to Edie about when I first came back from Hajj. We was in deep conversations a lot about Islam, and he accepted the religion of Islam. And the recently ones, I think Young Noble, he accepted Islam about a year ago.
Young Noble?
Young Noble is one of the members of the Outlaws. He accepted about a year ago. Castro accepted about 5-6 months ago.
Yeah.
You know, Hussein, he's a member of the Outlaws who accepted Islam when he was in prison.
Yeah.
So alhamdulillah, they're all Muslim.
Now some people might say, oh, this is a black thing. What do you got to say to that?
We would say for a fact that the religion of Islam is not a religion for black people, Arabs or white people.
Well, I'm not black, obviously.
You're European from Bosnia. Yeah. So this is, that'll be right there, proof against them or some hawk against them. But basically, I thought the same thing. Before I became Muslim, to be honest, The people that murdered my mother and father was from a group of people called the Nation of Islam.
Yeah, which has nothing to do with Islam.
Nothing to do with Islam.
I don't even like calling it the Nation of Islam. I'll say the
Nation of Kuf. Some people call them the Nation of Kuf.
Yeah.
So what I thought growing up is that these people are Muslim. They killed my mother and father in front of me when I was 3 years old. I would never be a Muslim. This is what I used to say. And it wasn't until I started to read the Quran and read about Islam, I said, wait a minute. The religion of Islam and what the Nation of Islam upon is two different religions. Yeah. You know what I mean? The religion of Islam, for example, we believe that Allah is the creator of the heavens and the earth. He's not a man. He's not a woman. He doesn't have a race. We can't even imagine Allah in our heads. We know that the Prophet Muhammad, he even said in authentic narrations that he was sent with something that no other prophet was sent with, and that he was sent to the whole of humanity. Yeah. For example, Jesus was sent only to the children of Israel. David to the children of Israel. But Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to the whole of humanity. And majority of the Muslims in the world are Asians. Indonesia, that's the biggest Muslim country in the world. Arabs, blacks, Bosnians, Europeans, you got Muslims everywhere. So this is the beauty of this religion. When I first went to Mecca and I noticed I seen people from all parts of the world, all parts of way of life, it was amazing. And everybody was treating each other like brothers. You know what I mean?
Dave Chappelle, who else? Yes. Scarface, some of these other...
Dave Chappelle, Scarface.
Shaquille O'Neal.
Is a Muslim.
Yeah.
Recently, Raekwon, he came to the masjid in Los Angeles. Raekwon from the Wu-Tang Clan.
Yeah.
He just accepted Islam. Ghostface Killer from the Wu-Tang Clan. I ran into him at the airport. He accepted Islam. So a lot of them is running to the religion, alhamdulillah.
Yeah, alhamdulillah, all praises to the creator of the heavens and earth who is guiding the people.
But you gotta want
to be guided, isn't it?
Definitely. We should want to search for the truth. And I think, and Allah knows best, that if we sincerely look for the haq, that Allah will guide us to the truth. You know what I mean? It's that the people, we can't sit back and just think that, okay, Allah will come down and speak to us, a'udhu billah, because some people have that mentality that they're not going to do nothing until they get a sign. The sign is that, look, man, look all around us. We see people dying every single day around us. We see what's happening to the people on earth all around the world. This is a sign, you know what I mean? This is a sign that we should take, we should want to know what's going to happen to us when we're dead. None of us know when we're going to die. None of us know when we're going to die. Every single person should at least be curious about what's going to happen to them in the next life. And we should want to be on the true religion in this life. So it's very important that if it's any non-Muslims looking, we would just ask you that you should read about Islam. You know what I mean? It's not going to hurt you if you go pick up the English translation of the Quran, and it's not going to hurt you if you go read the biography of the Prophet Muhammad. And we would tell you, basically, don't judge Islam by us. Because if you look at us and judge Islam, you will run away from it.
Yeah.
No doubt about it. But if you judge the religion of Islam by the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you would know what this religion is about. You know? A couple more.